Hi, this is Baron from Ragic. Today I'm going to show you how to create a running balance on Ragic. This is a very often asked question nowadays, so I decided to make a video tutorial out of it. So as you can see on my sheet, the subtable is updating the balance according to what the last transaction was. So how am I doing this? I created a new sheet from a subtable that I created over here. And we will go through this step by step, but basically whenever I do a new transaction, it will have to update the current account balance. So you can see it's the fourth transaction, which is the last that has been updating the account. So how do I do this? First of all, I will create a simple account sheet, and the way the transaction done is on another form so that it can update this. The calculation that you see is not done in the subtable. The only calculation that is done is showing the initial balance that was in a single transaction. So the others are not really calculated here except this field, which is grabbing the last balance. All the other calculations are done in a linked version, so I will show you how to do that from scratch. So, okay, let's create a new tab and our new sheet accounts under running balance. Okay, so I'm going to do the exact same thing from scratch so that you can see what I'm doing. Account number. Which is account, and the account name, which are my very basic fields. So what I need here is a subtable for my transactions, right? Transaction ID, which will start from, which will have the prefix of tries bind, and transaction date, which is a date field, okay. And then what we need is the amount, and that's obviously a money field, and the new balance. So what we need is the current balance, which is the initial balance on the first time. Where we will get the information in a bit. So these are my first fields I'm going to put. I'm going to put the initial balance of one transaction later on. And these are all the fields I need for now. So to start with an account, I will just create a company A. And let's say that they have a balance of $2,000. Okay, great. So what I need is a new sheet from my subtable, from sheet linking tools, new sheet from subtable for all the transactions. All the transactions are going to be needed to create it here. So I'll change the sheet name transactions. And you can see that it grabbed the account number since that was the key field from my account sheet. All of these other fields are from the subtable. So how do we calculate this? For the account, from the account, what I would need is the previous balance, right? So this current balance will be loaded when I select the account number. Okay, so the current balance is actually my previous balance, which I will add over right below the account number. And I don't want anyone to be able to change it, obviously, so I'm going to make it read only. And the amount is what I add to or subtract from the previous balance. And my new balance is going to be the result. So what I would do is A3 plus A6, which will calculate A7. Okay, so far so good. So what happens here is whenever you select the account number, the balance is the current balance, and you can enter a transaction date and the amount, let's say, is $100, which you can see is updated in the new balance. And if I save this, this would not update the accounts yet because the new balance is just a field in my subtable over here. So what I need for the current balance is to be updated according to the last entry of the subtable from the new balance, right? So the new balance is, we have a formula for this, last D6. So it will grab the last transaction's new balance. So I'm going to apply this formula, and you will see that it has updated according to this value. So that's basically what I needed, but I wanted to see the previous account balance as well. So I will add a new field, previous balance or initial balance over here, that will calculate that for me, which was D6 minus C6. And I will again apply this formula. You'll only have to do this once. I will give you the reason in a bit. I just saved the design, and I probably want to put this somewhere else, so I'm just gonna move it here, which is good. So we can see that the formula updated according to that. Okay, so and apply. Okay, so we can see that we started with 2,000 and then we added $100 to that and we got the 2,100. And as I said, you're going to want to update the records in the subtable from that other sheet because that's where the new balance is calculated actually. You don't want to update it here because we don't really have a formula for checking what this was. It doesn't work vice versa. So you are going to want to work on the sheet generated from the subtable instead. So how I'm going to do that is I'm going to go to my transactions and we'll do a couple more transactions to see how it goes. Account number this again. So you can see the previous balance is the last updated balance from our last transaction. And let's say we had subtracted $250. And you can see that new balance is $1,850 because we subtracted. And if we go back to the accounts and see, we have the updated current balance. And that's how you do a running balance. Okay, so for safety measures, we want to make sure that nobody enters data from the subtable. So I'm going to make all of the subtable fields read only. Like so. And also we want people to be able to enter data anyway from the new form though. So I'm going to do that by clicking the gear right next to the transactions over here. And you can see there's a create a button to add records with the new sheet. And I'm going to add that create new transaction, or you can name the button whatever you want to, and submit. And that will create an action on your sheet design over here. So this will pop up for any user that is looking at this. And you can see that you can't really edit anything from here. So you're pretty safe if you want to do that. So create new transaction would take you to the empty form with the account number and the transaction ID being generated. And you can say, add a new transaction for $230, let's say, and save. And this will update your account's balance. All right, so you have to remember that when you create a new account, the account name, let's say, is Company B this time, that you need to add a current balance in the first. Okay, if it can remain $0 if you're starting from ground, if you have a little capital, you can add it as the current balance, which will be the initial balance on your when you're creating a new transaction to start with, as you can see. Let's say we added 255. We can see that it updates our company B balance. All right, I hope this helps. I do get this question a lot, and you don't really have a way of doing this from one sheet, the account sheet on a subtable, but this is the easiest way to create a running balance on Ragic.